goodness, I have you guys like propped. You have no idea. Okay, so we're gonna do some nail art today. We're gonna do this super cute, pretty simple leopard print nail art. I posted a picture on Instagram and you guys were like, tutorial, tutorial, tutorial. So I give the people what they want. So the shades that we're gonna be using today are Essie Licorice, which is basically the only black polish that I use. It's amazing. Essie Less is Aura, which is our base color. This is a really, really pretty shade. And then our glittery shade is actually one of my creations with different dimension. It is called Hidden Penny, and it's pretty bomb. And then my top coat is from KB Shimmer. It is called Clearly on Top, and it is also amazing. So, if you guys wanna see how I got this cute little design, do you know what to do? Oh, and this is the little tool that we're going to be using. You can use a toothpick. I just chose to use this little orange stick. It's basically the same thing. Okay, so my base shades, I've already showed you guys. So I put two coats of each polish on. So once that's dry, give it at least 5 minutes and then you can start. So I take a little bit of black polish, blob it out onto, you can blob it onto anything. This is like a little dollar store number. So look how good I am. So my middle finger got a little bit blurry, but you'll get the gist, and I'll show you my index finger. Basically, what you want to do is make kind of abstract little C shapes, kind of like facing each other, but you want it to be as abstract as possible. You don't want there to be any sort of like actual pattern. Do you know what I mean? You just want it to be very random. So what I'll do a couple C shapes on like different areas of my nail, kind of like spread them out, and then I'll slowly start going back in and filling in the spaces. I mean, that's basically it in a nutshell. You don't want it to look too perfect, because when you think of leopard, it's not perfect. It's not like a very perfectly like clean lines. Do you know what I mean? It's kind of messy. It's kind of abstract is the best way to describe it. So even if you start to make a shape and you kind of mess it up, it's not really a mess up, because the more abstract it is, the better. Abstract is obviously going to be the word of the day. So I just keep doing the C shapes. Again, we're a little bit out of focus. It felt like my camera was so far away from my nails, but I actually feel like I was a little bit too close. Go figure. But all I do, I just keep dipping back into the black polish. And a little trick that I'll give you guys, oh, before I tell you that, once you have all your little C shapes done, I just go in and I fill in the spaces with like dots or lines, honestly, whatever you want. And once it all comes together, it looks perfect. A little trick, like about halfway through the nail, your polish might start to be drying out a little bit. Don't keep using that first blob of polish, because as it dries out, it's gonna get weird when you put it on your nail. It kind of gets gummy and you can get like little strings on your nail. So about halfway through, just get a new blob of polish. I know that might sound like common sense, but if you don't do nail art a lot, I don't really feel like it would be. So now we're doing the index finger. You can see from the jump what I'm doing here. Sorry, the middle finger was kind of a hot mess. Little C shapes, and you can kind of like drag your toothpick or whatever you're using, or you can do like little dots. If you think that you can't do like the draggy method, just do little dots like in a row, and it'll kind of give you the same effect. Yeah, and as I'm doing this, every time I look at my nail and I'm like, this looks insane. But I promise, once you get all of your little designs on there, it totally comes together and looks really nice. So stick with it. It's kind of like makeup. At the beginning of your eyeshadow, you're like, where in the name of all that is good am I taking this eyeshadow look? It looks crazy. But then when you get your mascara on, everything comes together. So doing my C shapes, I know it's kind of boring to watch, but I wanted to keep things in real time for you guys so that you can actually see what I do and not like speed through it, because I think it helps to see it done over and over and over again. But yeah, just keep making those designs. The more abstract, the weirder they are, the better it looks. And you can do them bigger. There are many, many ways to do leopard print nails. And a lot of people will kind of do your little, your two C's like facing each other, and then fill that in with a different colored nail polish. That's like your traditional leopard. But I don't know, I like this way. I feel like this looks a little bit more, dare I say, classy. I don't know, I feel like leopard is very classy, but it can also be very trashy. It depends how you style it. So yeah, that's pretty much it. I think you guys have seen enough. You got the gist. And honestly, you really can't mess this one up. There were a couple times in this actual nail art that I was like, oh crap, I just messed up. And it just made things look better because it's more, say it with me, abstract. So that is what we are left with. Now we're gonna go in and, of course, tidy things up. So on my pinky, I just put black polish, and I'll show you guys, I do two little dots, super easy, and it looks really cute. So I just take my little cleanup brush. You can use like an eyeliner brush, whatever you have. Now, usually I would do dots with a dotting tool, but I wanted to show you guys, it can be done with the toothpick. They're not the best dots in the world, but they're definitely doable. So I just took my base color for the leopard nails and made two little dots. It's so simple and it looks so cute. And then we are going to just clean up around the other nails, and you need to let this dry, you guys, seriously, for like 15 minutes. I let this dry for what felt like an eternity, and my index finger still smudged a little bit. So be patient. And then I take my top coat and I make sure I have a lot of top coat on my brush, because you don't want to be dragging your nail art. So make sure you have a good big old blob of top coat on your brush. Wrap your tip, go along the edge of your nail. That makes a big difference. And that's pretty much it. I know my cuticles are looking hella dry. I did put some oil on after I top coated. And those are my take on leopard nails. So hopefully you guys liked it. I think it looks really cute, and there are so many different color combinations that you can do. So yeah, I love you guys. I hope you enjoyed. I will see you next time. Bye. Oh, also, if you guys decide to do this nail art, please send me pictures on Instagram and Twitter and Snapchat. Okay, I love you. Bye.
Artistic, but you're actually not. Hi, my name's Nicole, and I'm not artistic, but I like to pretend that I am. Whatever, don't you agree? Well, that was my knee. Ow, oh my god. Why do I try to, like, kneel on the floor when I'm 90? Just don't.